Welcome to the problem number 1 of exercise 1.3. Here we need to show that root 5 is irrational. So we will start by assuming that root 5 is a rational number. Now if it is a rational number, we can write it in the form of a by b, where a and b are co-prime numbers. Co-prime numbers means they don't have any other common factor except than 1. So a and b are co-prime and b is not equal to 0. If b equals to 0, then this would have been a by 0, which would have lead to infinity. So we are taking b as not equals to 0. So a by b equals to root 5. Now we will take b that side. So b root 5 is equals to a. Now we will do square on the both the sides. So root 5 b, which was equals to a, now this becomes a square equals to 5b square. Now we know by the theorem that if p divides a square, then p also divides a. So here 5 divides a square, so 5 will divide a. So as 5 is a divisor of a, we can write a as 5 times c. Now we will do square on again both the sides. What we get is a square equals to 25 c square. So, and we know that a square is equals to 5 b square. So we write 5 b square equals to 25 c square. Now b square is equals to 5 times c square. So again, here 5 divides b square, because 5 is a factor of b square. B square is equals to 5 times c square, so 5 is a factor of b square. Hence 5 divides b square, and by theorem we know that it also divides b. So a and b have a common factor 5, so it contradicts our assumption that a and b were co-prime. We assume that a and b were co-prime, that is, it does not have any other factor except 1, but here we get that it has a common factor 5. It happened because we assume that root 5 is rational. Now this thing happened because we assume that root 5 is rational, but so it contradicts our assumption, and so root 5 is irrational.